लक्ष्मी प्रसन्न, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ ईसीई, इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ एरोनॉटिकल इंजीनियरिंग. वेलकम टू द लेक्चर सेशन ऑफ इमेज प्रोसेसिंग. इन दिस सेशन वी विल सी सम डेफिनेशन एंड टर्मिनोलॉजीज रिलेटेड टू मॉड्यूल 2. सो वी आर लर्निंग मॉड्यूल 2, दैट इज इमेज एनहांसमेंट इन स्पेशियल डोमेन. सो इन दिस मॉड्यूल 2 वी हैव लर्नड सम कॉन्सेप्ट्स लाइक बेसिक ग्रे लेवल ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन. सो इन दिस बेसिक ग्रे लेवल ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन सो वी हैव सीन पॉइंट ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन एंड ऑल्सो लीनियर ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन, लॉग ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन, पावर लॉ ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन, ऑल दीज ट्रांसफॉर्मेशंस वी हैव लर्नड इन अंडर दिस कॉन्सेप्ट. एंड नेक्स्ट कमिंग टू दिस हिस्टोग्राम प्रोसेसिंग. So we have learned what is histogram and histogram equalization, histogram matching and specification. So all these things we have learned under this histogram processing. Next coming to enhancement using arithmetic and logical operations. So we have learned how to enhance an image by applying this arithmetic and logical operation. So we have seen arithmetic operations like addition, subtraction, multiplication and division, and logical operations and or not, all these things we have seen. And coming to basics of spatial filtering, so we have seen some basics related to this spatial filters. Next, smoothing of spatial filters. Just we have seen some concepts under smoothing of spatial filters like linear and non-linear filters. So under linear filters we have seen mean filter. Under non-linear we have seen median, min and max filters. Shortening spatial filters. So under this shortening spatial filters we have discussed about two filters like Laplacian filter and gradient filter. And next one is combining spatial enhancement methods. By combining all these, how the effect will be. And next, introduction to the Fourier transform and frequency domain. So what is meant by frequency domain? How image enhancement will be done in frequency domain? And smoothing frequency domain filters. Smoothing under this smoothing frequency domain filters, we will learn low pass filter. Under low pass filter, we will learn different categories of filters like ideal low pass filter, Butterworth low pass filter and Gaussian low pass filter. So after that, sharpening of frequency domain filters. So in this sharpening frequency domain filters, we will learn about high pass filter. In that high pass filters, we will see different categories like ideal high pass filter, Butterworth high pass filter and Gaussian high pass filter. And the last topic we will learn is homomorphic filtering. So here we can observe this smoothing and sharpening at the initial case, they are related to spatial domain. And here we are learning about this smoothing and sharpening, they are related to frequency domain. So recalling all the concepts what we have studied, we will see some important definitions and terminologies related to this. So here, what is spatial domain? So in order to say in the simple manner, in the spatial domain, the operation will be performed directly on the pixel. So spatial domain methods refer to the image plane itself and involve the direct manipulation of pixels in an image. That means operation will be performed directly on the pixel. And next one is define contrast. So contrast is the difference between the maximum and minimum pixel intensity of the range. So maximum pixel intensity minus minimum pixel intensity represents the value of contrast. Specify the objective of image enhancement technique. That means what, why we are going for image enhancement technique. What is the objective? So the objective of image enhancement technique is to process the image So if we process the image, it is more suitable than the original image in order to undergo further process in particular application. Next, define additivity. So this is one of the property. So the property indicating that the output of linear operation due to sum of two inputs is equal to, that means is same as performing the operation on the inputs individually and then summing the results. This is called additivity. So first we can perform operation and then we can sum, or we can sum them individually and then we can perform the operation. That property is called additivity. So list the two categories of image enhancement. So what are different ways image enhancement can be done? One is spatial domain, which is called direct manipulation of picture image. Another name can be spatial domain. And another category, second category, is frequency domain, which is used for modifying the image by making use of Fourier transform. So write the properties of Haar transform. So the Haar transform is the simplest wavelet type of transform. And this transform, the function of this transform is, it is going to cross multiply a function against the Haar wavelet with various shifts and sketches. For example, Fourier transform can cross multiply a function against a sine wave with two phases and many stretches. And what is contrast stretching? So contrast stretching reduces an image of higher contrast than the original by darkening the levels below M and brightening the levels above M in the image. So here M represents the threshold value. So based on, by considering M, whatever the value is below M, that particular pixels will be represented as dark, and if the values are above M, that pixel contrast value will be represented as bright. So define mask mode radiography. It is a commercial use of image subtraction, that is, it is one of the masks which is used in radiography. So what is gray level slicing? So highlighting a specific range of gray levels in an image is called gray level slicing. For example, if you want to highlight any region of interest in an image, then this gray level slicing can be performed. And define masking, which is called filtering. So a mask is a digital image which is used to hide or reveal the operations on another image. So if we consider an image, this mask will be placed on the image. So if the mask is placed on the image, the operation will be performed. Either we can, it is used to hide that particular part of the image, or it is used to reveal the portion of that particular image. So define image subtraction. So the difference between the two images is called as image subtraction. So here the subtraction will be performed considering first pixel value of the image 1 and first pixel value of the image 2. After that, in order to perform the next operation, second pixel value of image 1 minus second pixel value of image 2. So what is image averaging? So image averaging is a technique that is often employed to enhance the video images that have been corrupted by random noise. So if any image is having some noise, for example, any video image is having some noise, in order to enhance that, we can perform image averaging. So this image averaging is the concept which is used for image enhancement. And define image multiplication. So that means if the multiplication operation is performed between the two images, then it is called image multiplication. So if multiplication is performed between two images, what happens means it is going to highlight the brightness of that particular image. So first pixel of image 1 will be multiplied with first pixel of image 2. After that, second pixel of image 1 will be multiplied with second pixel of image 2. So based on the multiplication factor, the brightness of the image will be changed. So what is meant by masking? So mask is a small two-dimensional array which will be consisting of some values, and that values can be called as mask coefficients, which determines the nature of process. And next one is define single pixel operation. So if in any procedure, or if any procedure is applied on the image and it is done on the image to alter the value of the individual pixel, then it is called as single pixel operation. That means if the operation is performed on a single pixel in the image, it is called as single pixel operation. And next, what is histogram? Histogram is the graphical representation of an image, which represents the frequency ranges. So histogram of an image is the representation of frequency of occurrence of each gray level in an image. So it represents how many pixel values are having same intensity. How electromagnetic wave can be visualized? So electromagnetic waves are visualized in the form of a sinusoidal waves. And what is median filter? So it comes under nonlinear filters. So the median filter replaces the value of pixel by the median of the gray level in the neighborhood of that pixel. So considering what are all the pixels that are under mask, among all the pixels we have to arrange in the ascending order. In that, after arranging in the ascending order, see which one is the middle pixel value. That pixel value will be replaced as the center pixel. What is soft X-rays? So soft X-rays will be having low energy, and they are used for dental and chest scans. Name different types of derivative filters. So here different types of derivative filters are Purvet operators, Robert cross gradient operator, and another one is Sobel operator. And next one is define brightness. So brightness is subjective descriptor of light perception, and it is not measurable. And what are different types of noise models? So here we have different types of noise models. Among them, Gaussian noise, relay noise, Erlang noise, exponential noise, uniform noise, and impulse noise. So all these are different types of noise models. And define photon. So we have learned this while discussing about electromagnetic spectrum. So massless particle containing a certain amount of energy is called photon, or it can also be defined as a bundle of massless energy is called photon. And what is monochromatic light? So light of mono means one. So light of a single wavelength can be called as monochromatic light. And define smoothing filter, which is called low pass filter, and it is used for blurring the images, and it is used to reduce the noise. So smoothing of filter is used for blurring, and it is used for noise reduction in the image. And what is average of pixels? So the output response of smoothing, we have seen there are two categories, linear and non-linear. So linear means it is averaging, which is also called as mean. So linear spatial filter is simply the average of pixels contained in the neighborhood of the filter mask. So we have to consider the center pixel, see what are all the neighborhood values, and then calculate the average values of that pixels, make it as a center pixel value. So what is smoothing linear spatial filter? Smoothing linear spatial filter is the average of pixels contained in the neighborhood of mask filter. And define blur edges. So edges which almost always are desirable features of an image also are characterized by sharp transitions in gray levels. What are the disadvantages of using smoothing filter? So if we use a smoothing filter, the image can be blurred. So define smoothing spatial filter. Smoothing filter is used for blurring and also for noise reduction in the image. And what is the function of sharpening filters? Sharpening filter can help to emphasize the details and enhance the edges of the image in an image. So the sharpening filter, especially, it is used to enhance the edges of the image. So what is non-linear smoothing filter? So the order statistic filter or non-linear smoothing spatial filters whose response is based on ordering or ranking of pixels. So ordering or ranking of pixels means we have learned under non-linear different cases like median, min filter and max filter. So in median, in all these three cases, first it should be arranged in all the neighborhood pixels will be arranged in the ascending order. In the median filter, we have to consider the middle value. If it is min filter, minimum value should be selected. And if it is max filter, maximum value should be selected. And all these selected values should be placed as the center pixel value. So all these are different definitions and terminologies we have seen in module 2. Thank you.
Like, share and subscribe. Hit the bell icon for more updates.